Hello sustainable growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics. In this video I would like to talk about a way to produce some food for your fish. Most of us, we are feeding our fish with some fish food pellets, and it's quite good for the fish. You know, the fish food pellets, if it's a good quality one, it's really adapted to the needs of the fish. But it's also good to sometimes change a bit what you give to your fish. If you can give them some living food, well, I'm talking about vegetables or worms or insects, it's going to add a lot of value to their diet. So that's something I really recommend, and in this video that's what I want to show you. I want to show you how to grow some fish food and what are the possibilities. So obviously in this video I'm going to focus on only one of them, but there are a lot of possibilities to grow or to find some different sources of fish food for your fish. In Melbourne Aquaponics we grow some silver perch mainly, we grow also some trout, but today I want to make a special zoom on the silver perch, because the silver perch is obviously a fish that can turn vegetarian when it grows, and you know, you got a lot of other fish that are going to accept some vegetables in the diet, the carp, the goldfish, all those kind of fish, they are able to accept a bit of green food basically. And in aquaponics obviously what you can do is to grow some lettuce, to grow some spinach, and to feed your fish with it. But I personally think it's a bit of a shame to feed your fish with something that you could eat directly, because as you know, the fish are not gonna transform 1 kilo of vegetables in 1 kilo of fish, right? There are a lot of waste. So what I recommend is to grow some green fins for your fish in an area where, basically an area that you don't use. This little setup here, well, basically I got a fish tank and a grow bed, but as you can see the grow bed is completely empty. And the reason why it's empty, it's because I use it as a demonstration. I want to show my customers how the bell siphon works. So I want to show them the level going up and down into the grow bed, what is normally the grow bed. So here we don't have any media, right? It's completely empty, it's only water. But as you can see, it's all green. And the reason why it's all green is because I put some kind of duckweed or aquatic plant to feed my fish. So those tanks that are the fish tank and the grow bed, that are demonstration tanks, I also use them to grow some duckweeds for the silver perch. And that's something you can do at home, just in a simple bucket. If you got a large tank, a bit shallow and large, you can just put a bit of water from your aquaponic setup, because this water, as you know, is quite high in nitrates, and that's basically a very good support to grow any plant, any vegetable. So you put a bit of this water in your bucket, and basically you put it in an area where there is not too much shadow, like exposed to the sun, with some duckweed on the surface. Duckweed are really quickly gonna multiply, and they're gonna cover the whole surface of the area. So by doing so, you're gonna be able to produce some free fish food for your fish, because it just takes a bit of water from your aquaponic setup. But it's really productive. You know, the duckweed, they are able to grow extremely quickly. So the duckweed is an aquatic plant that is growing on the surface of the water, not into the water. I think that's a fantastic way to produce some fish food, free fish food that is very high in vitamin. And if you mix it, you know, you give them maybe once a week or whatever. But whatever you can do, it's going to be a plus for your fish. There is only one issue when you put some water on a bucket outside, is that most of the time the mosquito are coming and they spawn into the water. By spawning into the water, they're going to basically create some larvae that could be also an excellent source of food for your fish. But if you don't grab the larvae, if you leave some larvae inside the tank, what is going to happen is going to develop more mosquito, and then you're going to multiply the number of mosquito you, you got around your place, and I don't think this is what you want. So what I recommend is to put some fish inside this tank. So you're gonna tell me, wait a minute, there is no much oxygen, how can I put fish here because we don't renew the water, water is sitting here. What you can do is to put some fish that have a very low oxygen consumption. So I'm talking about some fish such as maybe one goldfish or maybe some gambusia. You know, I don't know if you know gambusia. Have a look on the internet. Gambusia is called also mosquito fish because in some countries it's been used to basically eat all the larvae of all the mosquito larvae. So that's something very interesting to have in your aquaponic setup. And I mean, you can introduce them in your aquaponic setup, but it's very important to have some one or two fish in each tank that you have that you leave outside. In this case, they're gonna eat the mosquito larvae, so they're gonna have a very good source of food as well, and they're gonna avoid any mosquito to multiply in those tanks and to basically increase the population of mosquitoes around your place. So that's a good way to basically grow some green food for your fish without having any problem with mosquitoes. Below the duckweeds, I also grow some elode. This is an aquatic plant that is very well known by the aquarium keepers. So elode is a very interesting plant to have. It grows extremely quickly. And look at the productivity. You see the biomass I have here. I got plenty of it. The tank is full of this elode. You can also have some dragonflies that are going to spawn. You're going to have a whole ecosystem here as well. So this elode is going to be a good support for this ecosystem. So that's also something that you can grow easily for your fish and your crustaceans. So we have two kinds of duckweed. So this one is not the real duckweed. It's a bit thicker. So the fish don't really like this one. I mean, they eat this one, but they prefer the other kind, which is softer. This one is quite thick, if you look at it. You see, that's an aquatic plant that is living on the surface. And you see the roots are just falling down the surface. So the roots are here. And basically, if you leave it, it's going to cover all the surface and it's not going to leave any light underneath. So if you mix it with some elode, such as I do here, you see the elode is underneath. If you do that sometimes, you need to collect a bit of this special kind of duckweed or aquatic plant on the surface. Otherwise, you don't have any light and the elode that is below is going to die. And then we got the classic duckweed. So this one is really the duckweed that the fish love. So this one you see is very smaller, very much smaller. And the fish love this kind of duckweed. I even give some to my goldfish sometimes. They love it. So to collect your duckweed, you just take a very small net and you come on the surface. And just take it from the surface of the water. So it's very simple, you see. It doesn't take any time. You see the quantity I have here. You see the roots. I just take it and I put it in my fish tank. It doesn't take me a lot of time. Up. And this is it. The fish are gonna eat it whenever they want. And here you can see that the leaves that I gave them, I gave them a few. So you see they are attacking the leaves and sometimes there are some leftovers like now. And you see the holes. So they love to have some vegetarian food as well. Here we had some celery. Some holes are going inside. So I'm gonna leave it. So you see that's all compliments that you can give to your fish here, completely free. And it's really going to improve their diet. If you are watching this video on YouTube, you will see that on the description of the video just below, you will have access to some free gifts. First, you have access to a six-step process to be able to build your own aquaponic system in good conditions. I developed this six-step process because I found that too many beginners are basically starting aquaponics with a wrong design. So if you want to build your own aquaponic setup, please just follow those uh, six step process. It's completely free, right? I redesigned it to help you to build your setup in good conditions and therefore to succeed in aquaponics. The second gift is for people who already have aquaponics. A very common problem we have in aquaponics is that we got the leaves of the vegetables that are turning yellow. And the reason why is because basically in aquaponics we sometimes need to add some minerals, otherwise the vegetables have some deficiencies. So if you have this problem, I made a special video about it as well, and you can have access to it in the description of the video. It's the free bonus video. If you are very interested into aquaponics, you can also have access to a webinar, a free webinar specific to aquaponics. I deliver a lot of information. Finally, you are probably aware that I wrote a digital aquaponics manual called The Art of Aquaponics, and you can have access to a free excerpt of this aquaponics manual where I add a lot of value and I give you a lot of my knowledge about aquaponics. So don't forget that you can have access to those four gifts on the description of the video, and I'm sure they're going to help you to develop your aquaponics setup and to produce your own sustainable and healthy food in good conditions. Bye bye. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.